Okay, this is one of my favorite demonstrations that I do for my engineering thermodynamics class when I talk about the diesel cycle. What's great about this demo is that you can actually see the process of compression ignition, which is how diesel engines ignite their fuel without using a spark plug. Here you can see the piston and the glass cylinder. What I've done is cut a small piece of tissue paper and use tweezers to put it in the bottom of the cylinder. And then the plunger gets inserted, and we're ready to go. Here's a slow motion replay. Keep in mind that all I'm doing is rapidly compressing the air in the cylinder. There isn't any spark device or ignition source. Just the rapid compression of the air makes the paper combust, and rather explosively, which makes a pretty impressive demonstration. So here's a bit more explanation of what's going on. I've done the calculation, which I'll show you in a moment. And I've made a graph of the temperature of the air in the cylinder as a function of the cylinder volume. And here's a sketch of the piston-cylinder arrangement so I can show the compression. So we start off at some initial volume V1 at room temperature, and then the air gets compressed to about 1/20th of its original volume. As you saw in the video, all this happens in a fraction of a second, and there's no time for the air in the cylinder to cool. In other words, there's no time for heat transfer. That's what we call adiabatic compression. Amazingly, if you have perfect adiabatic compression, the air temperature rises to almost 700 degrees Celsius, well above the auto-ignition temperature of the paper. As I mentioned, this is what happens in diesel engines, which typically have a compression ratio of about 20 to 1. Near adiabatic compression in the cylinder ignites the fuel without the need for a spark plug. I could end there, but I thought I'd take this technical discussion a bit further, particularly for engineering students who've taken a course in thermodynamics. I'm going to go through the math behind the very high temperatures that you get when air is compressed rapidly. In thermodynamics, we model this problem as isentropic compression. And recall that for a process to be isentropic, it has to be both adiabatic and reversible. Adiabatic meaning no heat transfer, which in this case is reasonable because the compression is so quick. And reversible, meaning that it happens in a smooth, frictionless way without any energy losses. You can find the details of this analysis in any undergraduate engineering thermodynamics textbook. For an isentropic process, pressure times volume raised to the power of K is a constant, where K is the ratio of the specific heats of the gas. Cp is the constant pressure specific heat, and Cv is the constant volume specific heat. For air, K equals 1.4. Using the fact that PV to the K equals a constant, along with the ideal gas equation of state, PV equals RT, it's relatively easy to show that the temperature at the point of maximum compression is equal to the initial temperature times the compression ratio raised to the power of K minus 1. Now, for air, I mentioned that the ratio of the specific heats is 1.4, so this becomes T1 times the compression ratio raised to the power of 0.4. If we use an initial temperature of 20 degrees C, then T1 is 293 Kelvin. You have to convert it to Kelvin because all of these equations are based on the ideal gas equation of state. So we take 293 Kelvin times the compression ratio raised to the power of 0.4, and that gives 971 Kelvin, or almost 700 degrees Celsius for adiabatic compression. You can do a similar analysis for the pressure and show that the final pressure is equal to the initial pressure times the compression ratio raised to the power of k. The initial pressure in the cylinder is 1 atmosphere. And again, the compression ratio is 20 to 1 raised to the power of 1.4 gives a final pressure at the point of maximum temperature of 66 atmospheres. I should point out that this is just the temperature and pressure only due to adiabatic compression. When the paper auto-ignites, the temperature and pressure will go much higher, of course. Okay, so that's the basic thermodynamics calculation for isentropic compression. But you still might be wondering what's physically going on to cause the temperature of the air to rise. Well, there's at least two equivalent ways to think about this. One is the temperature rises because you're doing work on the system. It's forced through a distance to compress the piston, and that work is being added to a relatively small mass of air. Another way to think about it is on a molecular scale, the piston coming down rapidly is increasing the molecular kinetic energy. And as the kinetic energy of the air molecules rises, so does its temperature. Okay, I really love this demo, so I thought I'd show it one more time, but this time an outtake. I'm now banned from making videos in the kitchen. I came really close to breaking the ceiling light fixture. As an end note, I should mention that this demonstration was done using a professional grade piston-cylinder apparatus made by Pasco. It's quite expensive. I think it costs about $300, but it's much more robust and works a lot better than the inexpensive ones you can buy at most science stores. I'll put a link to where you can buy it in the description. I hope you found this video helpful.